Oh, hi. Didn't see you come in. Come in. Welcome. Glad you could join us. Today we're here to talk about manners in a public setting. Think of this as a how-to video. How not to be a jerk to everyone around you. Over the next few minutes, we'll discuss how to make sure you properly portray yourself in a public setting. Some of these topics will involve directly interacting with other people, and some you'll just do on your own. But we've got a lot to cover, so let's get started.
Holla at your boy.
For our first example, we'll cover automobile etiquette. The first thing your parents taught you was to say please and thank you. The traffic equivalent to that is the wave after someone has let you in. Let's see if we get that wave. No wave, no surprise. As we see here in this car, two guys riding together to their destination. As you can tell, the gentleman in the driver's seat is really enjoying listening to Earth, Wind, and Fire while he drives. Captain Cranky Pants over there just tolerates it so that he doesn't have to drive. Ah, that's his phone ringing. Looks like we'll have to pause that song for just a second.
Hello? Hey, what's up, dude? No, it's fine. I'm just riding around with Jeff.
Notice how the driver is now stuck in silence while the passenger continues to have his conversation.
So, I mean, CBA, collective bargaining agreement, you know what that all means. It's an agreement between labor and management, and out of the old collective bargaining agreement.
Still going.
And as such, they now have to sign a new one for any sort of like business interactions to occur. So what happens is the players right now are asking to see the owner's books because the owner's main contention is that they're
He's
not making enough.
Still going.
The owners are saying that they've never shown them before, so why would they need to show them now? And there's a few other little things in there, like the things that they're going to go over are going to be like rookie pay scale instead of like
all of this could have easily been avoided by letting the call go to voicemail.
And,
God forbid.
Both sides kind of want that to happen, but as of right now.
Next, we'll cover bathroom manners. Besides for the hygiene factor, you just got to know, no touchy. Now, this seems to be just a regular trip to the bathroom. Let's see how it unfolds.
Jeff, what's up, buddy? How's the pup?
Good, I guess.
Besides for making the guy uncomfortable, he also touched his junk by proxy. So remember, no touchy. Part 3 will be how not to be a jerk while shopping in public. First, we'll cover the buggy. Ah, the buggy. With a little tiny metal bumper just high enough for everyone's ankle, make sure to pay attention where you're headed. That had to hurt. Next, we'll cover interacting with your fellow shoppers. Make sure to be courteous to everyone around you.
What up, dude?
What's up?
What are you up to?
Just shopping.
In the hospital?
No, I'm in the pharmacy.
Steve stabbed the guy?
What?
So remember, always be courteous to everyone around you. Good rule of thumb, treat each and every person as if they were your own grandmother. All right, Grandma! I'm trying to record something!